Kilim 9 for Golf, runway 27, clear to land.
I'm at the top of Schiphol Air Traffic Control Tower.
And just saw was a VFR departure.
So the one I'm actually interested in is the Orange Pride.
Yeah, that's the special livery of KLM.
KLM 589 here, QNH 1015.
You have five runway and a small little runway here.
We have six in total.
Six. Get a 1824, turn left heading 225.
So we want to see how you guys work. Give us some behind the scenes stuff.
Yeah, we'll do that. Just follow me and I'll show you around.
Hey, welcome to Amsterdam, guys. Right behind me, the Schiphol Airport Tower, one of the busiest air traffic control tower. Today I'm having a tour. Let's check it out, guys. Hi, Jos.
Hi, Sam.
Hi. How are you doing?
I'm really good. How are you?
Wow. I'm at the top of Schiphol Air Traffic Control Tower.
Yeah, it's really great to have you here. It's our pleasure.
KLM 589, taxi to runway 24.
Degree views. How many runways here? Look at how many planes here. How many runway there is?
Well, Sam, we actually have six runways which we can use. And normally we're only allowed to use three runways at the same time because of noise abatement. Averagely, we do on a daily basis, we do 1500 to 1600 departures and landings. And
wow.
Our hourly rate is about 110 to 120 aircraft.
That's a lot, 110, 120 per hour.
Yeah, it's kind of pretty hectic here in the summer.
Yeah. Just to let you know, Jos is an AF geek and I'm an AF geek. So when two AF geeks meet on the control tower, this is a playground. You know, what's the special plane today? Show me.
Yeah, one of the special planes is the first visit of the EgyptAir 787.
Oh, EgyptAir.
Yeah, they just changed from a 73 or the A330 on the number line.
I saw my favorite 747, KLM 747 taxiing out.
This is the top of the airport in the tower. We actually just renovated our tower. We went up from 10 working positions up to the 15 we have now. We built an extra level, which where you're at the moment right now. And there at the moment we have five controllers working. We have the tower controller working, departures and landings on 18 center. And 18 left, we got an assistant controller here. He's doing the tow traffic. This is one of the ground controllers. He's doing all the pushback and taxi and traffic on the north side of the airport. This is the outbound planner. She makes sure that everybody has his departure clearance before he's going to get pushback. And she makes also sure that there's a lot of enough traffic going onto the departure runways and not too much as well. Here at Amsterdam, we like to absorb the delay on the ground at the gate because it's better for the environment. So. And the last position here on the first level is the ground controller, which is responsible for the traffic on the south part of the airport. So at the moment she's working all this traffic here, and she's making sure that everybody can push back safely and taxi to the departure runway into his gate. What you just saw was a VFR departure. We have some VFR traffic station. That's police helicopters and Coast Guard Dunier. They do pollution control on the North Sea. So he just departed Amsterdam. He's going to the west.
In Amsterdam, the challenge is the wind change a lot. So I have seen now a lot of runway change. Every few hours, there's a runway change. Now we see the planes approaching from the north. Earlier, it was approaching from the south. And you know, it's very fast paced moving here.
Sam, I'll tell you a little bit more about the workflow we have here in the tower. So, for instance, we have the KLM 589, which is the Orange Pride, which you see departing in a couple of minutes. KLM 589 is his departure of 18 left, going to Accra today. And you can see here the digital flight strip. We changed from paper strips to digital flight strips about half a year ago when we refurbished the tower as well. All the details are on the strip. You got the KLM 589, departure runway 18 left, and his SID, CUDA 1 Echo departure. Also, type of aircraft is 777.
So this strip, it passed from one controller to the next controller as the identification of the aircraft.
Exactly. And now we have great visibility today, so we actually don't use the ships.
So when you clear weather, you can also visualize, you can see the plane, right?
Exactly, yeah. The basic work here in the towers is just on visual, you do visual control. There's a visual control room over here. You see the delivery controller here. So he will tell the departure airway clearance to all the pilots when they
So
they
he's the first person to talk to the
Exactly,
captain.
This is the start of the flight.
So the one I'm actually interested in is the orange pride, the orange and blue 777-300, right?
Yeah, that's the special livery of KLM.
There's a list of planes. He's a busy man here. This is a busy position.
At the moment, we have two runways in use, so that means about 80 departures an hour. So he'll be giving 80 departure clearances this hour. So yeah, it's quite a busy position.
That's challenging. That's a very busy position.
Exactly.
KLM 589, QNH 1015, information whiskey, contact ground, 1:1.805. KLM 589, goeiedag, startup and push bulletproofed.
Sam, you just heard the KLM 589 got his clearance for pushback. So we will be pushed back straight backwards and then pulled out. After the pull out, he will start up his engines and give us a call when he's ready to taxi to the runway.
KLM 589, on a sequence, land number 8, one is left, equal 6. Level weight, echo 6, KLM 589, runway 1 is left, equal 6, clear for takeoff, wind is 16013, maximum 19er.
KLM 31 November, the wind is 240321, 21, maximum 31, runway 2405, clear for takeoff. KLM 9 for Golf, runway 27, clear to land, the wind is 240321, 21, maximum 30.
What you just saw was the outbound rush, a lot of heavy departures, and you see all the gates are clear now. For the next hour and a half, all the inbound rush will start, and then we have all the gates filled up again. What you see on this screen, about 80% of all passengers here in Amsterdam, they don't actually leave the airport, but they just only transfer from one plane to another.
Yeah, I think Schiphol is one of the top three busiest airport in terms of movement in Europe, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, even in passenger-wise. Yeah,
even passenger-wise, number three.
Yeah.
It's huge.
Yeah, it's really
huge
really
for
busy.
A small country like Netherlands.
Yeah, exactly. Mm.
So 18 right, this is the Polder Bar runway. It's very far, right? But it's really good for spotter, taking pictures, right?
Yeah, it's really good access. You can take beautiful pictures down there, but most pilots, they don't like to land on that runway because you have 15-minute extra taxi time to get here.
Right, long taxi back to the main terminal. Yeah?
Exactly, yeah.
Right, so you're closing down 27, avoiding runway crossover with departure runway.
Exactly, we like to avoid runway crossings where we can because it's a potential hazard, and to avoid that, we close down 27 and start landing 18 right again.
It's a bit complicated because here it's got six runways. You got to know your bearings because you got 18, 36, 09, 27, 06, 24. 18, they have three runways, left, center, and right. So, and then there's 04 and 22. So, you know, because the wind, this all runway direction can be in use to battle with a crosswind. Do you see a lot of these go around at the tower every day?
No, it doesn't happen a lot. Normally, the pilots know how to vacate, and they do expedite vacate the runways here because we have close separation on final.
What's your separation like? 45, 60 seconds?
We're up to 80 to 90 seconds.
Up to 80, 90 seconds?
Yeah,
okay.
With four landings. Departures, it's about 50 to 60 seconds between departures. I really hope you enjoyed your visit here in the tower. I actually have a bunch of more colleagues working air traffic, but not only in the tower, but also in radar and area control. So I'd like to invite you to the eastern part of the airport where our radar center is.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice
I'm Maggie.
To meet you.
Welcome to the radar control center at Schiphol Airport. I'd like to show you how it works.
Let's check it out.
Yes, this is where all the magic happens.
Chinese and 772 Fuddle.
Get him 959, Lambda 1130.
Get him 1395, proceed direct to 8 Vodafone. Chance 7 Echo Tango, conduct Schiphol approach, 119.055.
Get him 751, good radar descent, conduct arrival, 118405.
Sam, this is a radar screen and it gives you a representation of the airspace that we work. Have you ever seen a radar screen before?
No, to be honest, I only saw Flight Radar 24 on my cell phone, but this is a real radar.
This is a real radar and this is the Dutch airspace. The Dutch airspace is worked by myself and the other colleagues from the ground up to 24,500 feet. So as you can see on the screen, all the white targets are aircraft, the labels, and all the little green blips that are moving, those are all aeroplanes. The ones with white labels are ones we are working, and the ones without is traffic working with other sectors. So you can see it is a pretty busy airspace.
Xavier 96 Alpha, climb to flight level 270 and proceed direct to Birmingham.
Let's check out. I'm really interested. I want to see this one, KLM 877.
Yeah. Yes.
See what kind of airplane, because you can tell.
Yeah. Everything is down here. It's a Dreamliner.
787 Dreamliner.
Yep, it's going to Bombay.
Yeeham to Bombay.
Yep, to Bombay. Yes, and all the details are there, so it'll be the time he gets airborne.
He's already departed.
He's outbound. Yeah, he got airborne at 11, so 10 minutes ago. And now he's already going to be working with the Maastricht sector.
What's the speed you can show here? Right?
His actual speed that he's doing is indicated as 345 knots. Mm-hmm. That's actually what he's flying, because this is the information we get directly from the aeroplane. The pilot selected level is flight level 250, so that's what he's been cleared to by us. The heading is flying, and then his rate of climb at the moment, 1,700 feet. Wow. So we have all of this as backup information to make sure that what we are saying the pilot is doing, that he selects the correct level. It's an added safety measure that we have.
Anything up to 24,500 is in the radar room here, controlled by here.
Yes.
But on the radar screen, there's a lot of green dots as well. Those are also within the vicinity in the Dutch aerospace.
Our area only goes up to 24,500 feet. Anything above that is working with the next sector, which in this case is Maastricht Eurocontrol. They're in Maastricht and they have upper area sectors.
So the high flyover traffic is controlled by Eurocontrol in Maastricht.
I will work with him, and then at a certain point I'll hand him over to the next controller. So it's basically a chain of controllers from the minute the pilot requests startup to the minute his engine shuts down at his destination. There'll be a chain of controllers that he will go through, starting at a ground controller, a tower controller, an approach controller, an area controller, and then vice versa when he descends.
So you're the area controller?
We are area control.
And there's a higher area control in Eurocontrol and Maastricht?
Yeah, and they sit just above us, and then the English will be just next to us, and the Belgians will be south of us, and the Germans to the east. So everybody has their own frequency, and when he's finished with me, I say, now contact my colleague in Germany on the next frequency, and then I say goodbye, and he'll call up in the next sector, and the next sector will say hello, and take the flight for the next section.
KLM 97 November, further left onto heading 105.
We can show you an example of a flight that's currently working with us. It's a KLM 1074. He comes in from the UK to Amsterdam. He enters the airspace via one of the three initial approach fixes that we have. So basically all the highways in the sky meet at three points. And from those three points, our approach colleagues put them behind each other on the runway that they can land. So the task of an area controller is to take them from all different directions, all different aircraft types, put them behind each other, similar speed, similar height, and then the approach controllers will take those streams and make one stream out of that, or two streams, depending on how many runways. At the moment, as you can see here, we have one landing runway and two departing runways, so it's an outbound peak, and later on when it gets busy, that swaps around, we'll have one departure runway and two landing runways, and that rotates through the whole day, depending on the peak of the day.
Goedemiddag, information is Charlie, expect Alice number 18 right.
Kera 1824, turn left heading 225, descent 2000 feet, clear Alice 18 center.
Sam, sitting behind us are our approach control controllers for Schiphol. They will speak to the aircraft just after they're airborne, before they hand them over to us on area control, and also just before they land. So we will sequence them from area, and the approach controllers will put them on final approach for the runway to land.
So the plane took off, they spoke with the tower, tower hand over to this area.
A firm to approach, they will then climb them to a certain level and then they will hand them over to area. And vice versa, coming inbound, we will hand them over to approach. Approach will descend them, position them onto the final approach for the runway and hand them over to the tower controller who will then clear them to land.
Right, so the name is approach, but really they do both departure and landing as
That
well.
Is correct, they do the airspace directly around the tower itself. So whether it's incoming or outdoor traffic going out, they will work the area.
Can I say like it's almost like level one is actually the tower and level two is here. And then the next level is the area controller, level three.
We see it a lot like little cake tins. We have the tower controller, that's the first cake tin, the approach controller that's just above that, and the area controller that's above that. So it works in layers.
Thanks for so much for explaining all the feature radar room, because I always thought that was rocket science. It's like looking at a screen at a tower, people get to visualize the view, the traffic, but in the radar room, you're just basically looking at a screen, talking to the plane, you know, tough work.
It is, but I love it. I've been doing it for over 20 years, and it is very interesting. People always associate air traffic control with the guys that sit in the tower, but it goes much deeper than that. There's those of us that sit behind the radar screen with the little green blips, basically, and we keep them separated. We put them behind each other. We keep them safe from their departure points to their destinations, and it's a fantastic career. I'm hoping maybe we can get some of the young people that don't know much about air traffic control but are interested in aviation to delve a little bit deeper into what we do. It is a fantastic career, very exciting, every day is rewarding, and I can
not as stressful, not as hard as people think.
Not
right?
at all. The training is fantastic, and if it's something that you enjoy and something that you can do, then it actually is very simple.
That's great, but thank you so much for keeping the sky safe for us.
Absolutely. Thank you, so much thank you Sam, for visiting. It was a pleasure.